Get ready to match the stars from Lou Grant, Robert Walden, Brett Summers, Charles Dawson Riley, Henry Lander, Bert Conde, and Patty Newcastle as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 79. And now, here's the star of Match Game 79, Gene Reivers.
Right. Ready?
Ready.
For what?
Whatever you say.
Oh, whatever dear. I say. Well, let's
now,
go.
Wait a minute.
Match game, all right.
Wearing it down already, yes. Huh?
You look adorable.
Thank you.
Gentlemen,
you couldn't make up your mind what to wear today?
Nothing matches, does it?
No, I like that.
They're all nice.
Reminds
Thank
me
you.
Of back east.
No, it got
back
it.
East.
Yeah.
Is that where you're from?
Yeah.
Good. Thank you very much.
The
all right,
far
if you're
east.
Ready, let's have a go at it. Yes, we'll sir. Say hello to our current champ, Trina McVeigh. Yeah. That's it. Trina McKay.
No, wrong.
Trina McKay.
Yes.
How much did you win in the previous time you were here?
$350.
$350.
You mean yesterday?
No, I don't mean yesterday. I mean the previous appearance. Did you win anything? Sure you did.
Okay.
Was it $800? My memory's...
$100.
Oh, all right. Well, she's doing okay. She was recalled because I made a little goof, and then she came back here and she won the game. She's got a total of $350 now. We're into the audience match part of it, and you're going to spin the wheel in a moment or so and determine whether you'll be playing for $2,500 or $5,000. You ready for that?
Yes.
Okay, we'll do that right after we do this. Here we go. Okay. You've got the $250. Remember, the least you play for is 10 times that amount, or $2,500. But if you get a lucky spin of the wheel, you double that money, and you play for $5,000. Good luck, Trina. Go. Oops, got to make one revolution. There it goes. It was a weak spin, but that doesn't make any difference. It could be a double. Going to play with Big Chuck up there in the upper right-hand corner.
Show me that, too.
Good luck to you, Trina. Here it is. Remember, your response will be verbal. He will write his down. This is it. Blank horses. Or blank horses. Okay, Trina, give us the answer that Charles has written on the card. If you do that, we give you $5,000. What do you say?
Racehorses.
Racehorses. Good. Reasonable answer, I think. I hope you're on the same wavelength as Charles. She says racehorses, Charles.
I'm sorry, I said wild horses.
Wild horses. Now, wild horses is not a bad answer. Very Don't boo him because he'll walk that. Out. We
wild
need him.
Wild horses couldn't drag me out of it, right?
Right.
We all have wild horses.
What's that?
We were all wild. Wild got a big vote. Yes. The whole front row is wild.
Wild horses. No, okay.
I would have said race. Race.
Who asked you already?
But I'm not as good as this. It's Charlie.
Oh, all right.
Charlie is.
Trina, let's meet your new challenger. Now, here comes Janet Harris Ford. How are you?
Okay, I'm doing fine.
Good. Now, we want to get acquainted with you a little bit before we start the game here.
Okay, I'm a Southern girl. I was born in Bessemer, Alabama. Great. I grew up in Pasadena, Texas. I moved to Los Angeles to pursue my career as an actress, and I work at a local health food store. That's how I support myself.
Are you healthy?
Yep. Don't I look healthy?
Yes, you look wonderful.
Thank
You're
you.
Full of vitality and energy.
It's all those vitamins.
Yes. I think our motor's running, don't you? Okay, let's get on with it here. Janet, you can have A or B.
B.
B, all right. B complex, vitamins.
Uh-huh. I took some today.
Fred said, something crazy has happened to my television set. I can see a cartoon and the news at the same time. It's strange. The news is being hosted by blank. That's good. Yeah, just put it right in there. Okay, everybody ready? Here we go with Janet Harris Ford. Fred said something crazy has happened to my television set. I can see a cartoon and the news at the same time, and it's strange. The news is being hosted by...
Mickey Mouse.
Mickey Mouse. Mickey Mouse is the granddaddy of all the cartoon characters, the most prominent one through the years, and that's why she said that. And she's hoping you said it, Robert.
I knew when her motor was running that we were
on the same wavelength.
I said Mickey Mouse, and I'm sorry.
Okay, right. Now, what do you say, Brett?
Well, on the off chance that they were... What are you doing with Mr. Conley?
Nothing.
Are you too far?
Yes.
Nothing.
He just gave me a blank right there.
Oh, yes, I've had one of those. It doesn't take a minute. I fucked myself up. I said Donald Duck.
Donald Duck. We want... Oh, what's it say there, Charles?
It says that the creators of Felix the Cat are suing you for claiming Mickey Mouse to be the father of the cartoon.
Well, I don't know.
Your history books will show you Felix the Cat was there first.
No doubt about that, but...
But you don't want to hear those kind of things,
do
you?
No, I don't want to hear those.
You'll go with the old commercial Disney World, Disneyland, well, people like Mickey Mouse.
Oh, yes, of course. Okay, so that's two for Janet Harris Ford there. Are you ready?
Yes. I said Donald Duck. I thought that would be pretty funny.
You thought that'd be funny?
Yeah.
See, to be funny is my job.
Like,
you write the answers that you think would match her. You think it would match her. That's the whole idea there. Got it?
Yeah.
Write us a song. Okay, Bert.
Speaking of that.
Yes.
You made a mistake when you talked about Audrey's song. Did you know that? Did you know you did?
Now, wait a minute. They told me in the dressing room that I said, the apple doesn't fall far from the tree.
That's close. I didn't have as good English as you did.
And the real title is, the apple don't fall far from the tree. But it just goes against my grain.
I knew that.
But doesn't is hard to sing. The apple doesn't fall. The apple don't, you know?
Yeah, now how does it? Just sing that one phrase.
You want me to sing it?
I would like to hear how it goes.
Okay.
To see if it would fit
all
in.
Right. And the apple don't fall far from the tree.
Oh, you couldn't say
that. Apple doesn't
and the
fall.
Apple doesn't fall. No. All right, you're right.
How did she get all those notes into that one sentence? That was terrific. Said, you know, sometimes it's hard to tell the difference between the news and the cartoons anyway, so you wouldn't even notice if it was Goofy doing the news. Is what
Goofy was doing the news. Another character?
He's a good friend of Mickey Mouse's, you know.
That's right.
Oh, he's very close.
I can see the cartoon and the news at the same time on my crazy television set, and it's strange. The news is being hosted by...
Yeah, that's all.
What's funny, she said. Picked up two there. We'll have one for you. Right now, we have this for America. Now, are you ready?
Yes.
This is your round one question. Remember, you can go far afield with those. Norm said... I'll bet that wino used to be rich. Instead of drinking out of a brown paper bag, he drinks out of a blank.
You know, when Bowery Bums drink out of a brown paper bag?
Yeah. Why are they laughing? I just don't...
This wino drank out of a blank. Ready, Patty? Okay. Norm said, I'll bet that wino used to be rich. Instead of drinking out of a brown paper bag, he drinks out of a blank.
A gold paper bag.
I couldn't think of anything.
They're restless tonight.
Okay, show us your bag.
I almost said gold, but I was ashamed.
Gucci bag.
Gucci bag is what I said.
The machine that's that too.
Yes.
yes, of
How
course.
How do you spell it? I've had that.
G-U-C-C-I.
I always jog by that place.
Yes.
And hold on to my pockets.
The way you spell it, it would be Gucci.
Gucci.
Yeah, the C-H-I combination in Italian is ca. What do you say?
I won't say that their luggage runs
right,
in the rain.
Right. No, absolutely.
Even though it might, if you owned any.
Yeah, yeah, she spelled it.
Unfortunate. G-O-O-C-H-Y, Gucci bag.
Right, Gucci bag.
Oh, Gucci bag.
Gucci, Gucci. Hello.
Gucci, Gucci.
What are you staring at, Charles?
He's waiting for landing instructions.
Camera one.
Okay, those of you with an editorial retort to Miss Summers' views on hospitals, politicians, and Gucci, I said Gucci.
Gucci.
And if it runs, that ain't so bad. You know why?
Why?
Because you don't have to carry it to the airport.
Went a long way to get that one, Chuck.
Very good. Very good.
I thought you were building up to the fact that you were going to offer equal time for Brett's... yes, hello.
Gucci.
Gucci it is. All right, show us your bag.
I said I drank out of a silver thermos.
A silver thermos?
That's because that's what he
You're
drank
so
out
affected, Bert Condy, with sick of you.
It's as good as Gucci.
It's what Vegas does to you.
You drank out of a Gucci a flask in that movie we did.
Yeah, that's right. I forgot about that.
A Gucci shoulder strap purse.
Gucci shoulder strap purse would be wonderful. Now let's go to round two and ask Janet if she wants A or B.
B, please.
Okay. Robert and Charles, you lay out. The rest of you, please respond to this. The forest ranger said, the drought this year is really affecting the salmon. Instead of swimming, they're blanking upstream. Really a bad drought. Poor salmon. Okay.
I just thought of a better one.
Ready.
That's good.
The forest ranger said the drought is really affecting the salmon. Instead of swimming, they're blanking upstream.
Drinking.
Drinking.
Drought?
No. The drought is really affecting the salmon.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of swimming, they're blanking upstream. And you say drinking upstream, and you're going to stick with it.
Well, can I change?
No. Sorry. All right, Brent.
I think she misunderstood the word drought, possibly, because... I said they were walking or stumbling.
Walking or stumbling? Yeah.
I get it.
You understand
you
it now, Jane?
Yeah, a little late, but...
She said she just understood the question this moment. But
me
there
too.
We go. No, let's see what you have.
Well, I know you looked at me funny, but I put crawling, because you know, when you die for running,
Would you like to give us a demonstration on the floor?
I'd pay $1.25 to see that, I tell you that.
Show us how a trout... Show us how a trout crawls upstream.
She really makes you a mess. You know, you are a mess.
Funny you don't get flustered when you talk to me like that.
What'd you say, Bert?
Well, I think that... I said hiking. They're now hiking upstream.
Hiking upstream. Okay.
You I wish I had
up.
Said my second thought. My second thought was backpacking, but my first thought was walking.
Walking upstream, of course. Okay,
like
middle of round two. You'll have a shot at it in a moment or so. Right now, we got a message for you. Pay attention.
So does our star, Gene Rivers.
Here we go. Now, Tina, this is the way it is. You need two to tie and three to win. Nancy, the nurse, said, I think that surgeon used to be an auto mechanic. He tried to start the patient's heart with a blank.
Stop looking at my card for 6 years.
He's so crazy.
The grammar was incorrect there. For 6 years, you have been looking at my card, period.
You
Please
forgot
stop.
Felix the cat.
Excuse me, I have to ask.
What?
He's very fortune matcher, so I know he'll know what this is.
Get far from the microphone so you All right.
In fact, get even further from the microphone, like Sepulveda Boulevard.
Here we go, Trina. Nancy, the nurse, said, I think that surgeon used to be an auto mechanic. He tried to start the patient's heart with a blank.
Jumper cable?
Jumper cable.
She asked me for advice. Yeah. I didn't open my mouth. She writes down what she wants. I write down wrench and I'm wrong.
Uh-huh. Okay. What do you got?
And I wrote down cable jumper, and I'm right.
Cable jumper.
A jumper. Well, I mean, either way.
I've never known a cable jumper. But...
Have you ever known a jumper cable?
Hello, Chuck.
All right, Gene, mechanic. I said, like all guys, like all rugged guys, you can tell by my outfit.
Yeah, you're a mechanic. And blue. Auto mechanic, right?
Yo!
Right.
Jumper cable.
Jumper cable, right. Well, it's time for you two. One more pair of jumper cables. Cable jumpers will win the game. All right, Audrey, go.
Battery jumper cable.
Battery jumper cable. Well, Janet, good luck to you in your theatrical career.
Thank you. Hope we'll do better at that than I did.
Oh, you're going to be grand. And we'll send some gifts from Match Game 79.
Thanks.
Janet Harris Ford. Okay. Now you got $450. Going to have another go at it here. We polled the studio audience not too long ago, Trina, and said write down your best answer to this. Blank of the North.
Oh, boy.
Number 500 for the most popular. 250 for the second most popular, and 100 for the third most popular response written by those people.
Brett.
Nanook of the North!
All right, there's one.
Bert.
I'm in trouble.
Nanook was my best.
Yeah.
North.
Now think about it. There are a couple of other good ones.
Well, think of weather, of storm.
Oh, I got one.
You do?
Wait a minute.
Can I be coached?
Don't any. Wait. Just something. Sometimes things come to you. You never know. They come from heaven. They just fall into your lap. Oh, I'm going to get you for that.
Wicked Witch of the North.
Wicked Witch of the North.
It just came to me.
It's not the Wicked.
It's in my mind.
It's not Wicked.
It's not Wicked. The Witch of the North.
Mounties of the North.
Mounties of the North?
It's not the Wicked Witch of the North.
You mean Sergeant Preston of the North?
Red uniforms
and the funny hat?
And friends, all personal friends.
Right.
Doesn't matter, Nanook is the answer.
Sunny Gale.
Yes, that's right.
Okay, you have Mounties of the North, Nanook of the North, and the Wicked Witch of the North. You may choose one of those or think up one of your own.
Nanook.
You want Nanook? We all want Nanook. Nanook?
It's the Wicked Witch of the
World. Well, Nanook, there was a story written about many years ago. Many years ago, there was a story written about Nanook of the North. And it was a very famous story. And they made a motion picture out of it. It was one of the earliest documentary pictures ever made. Oh, she says she's sorry she asked now. All right. Let's see if we got, what did you choose, Nanook of the North, up there on a $100 number? King of the North.
King of the North.
What does that mean? That
they were desperate, that's what it means.
That means it's a rotten answer is what that means. All right, let's look at the next one, please. Star of the North.
The North Star,
Star is what I always say. I never say, hey, look at the Star of the North.
No, it's the Star of the East.
Look at the North Star. All right, last chance for Nanook. Show yourself if you're up there, Nanook, you rascal little Eskimo. Yeah. You don't know who Nanook is. She still doesn't know who Nanook is. All right, now that means you won the $500. The least you'll play for is 10 times that amount or $5,000. But if you're lucky here, you double the money and play for $10,000. Give it a go. Let's see if she gets a double. Why, Robert, are you ready?
All no, right, but I'm here.
Write an answer to this if you would, please. $5,000 is at stake for this lady, and this is what it says on this card. Turn it blank. Turn it blank. Okay, he's finished. Trina, you give us the answer that he's got on the card. If you do that, we give you $5,000. That's all there is to it.
Turn it on.
Turn it on! Okay, Robert, she says turn it on.
I turned it off.
Oh.
Well, there were two choices.
Why would you do that? Turn it off. Well, that's good. Turn it off, turn it on.
Turn it on. Turn it off.
Turn it out.
Turn it around.
Turn it around.
Turn it down.
Too many choices.
Little by little, you're piling up a little money here. You now have $950. And now we've got this message for you. It's time to say goodbye. Say goodbye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. You're a wonderful George here in that game. Join us next time on Gene Rayburn, Dally Ho.